Hey everyone out there, I want to do a video on this very special day, the 5th of April. I don't know if it is a special day for you, but it's a very, very special day for me. Because it's my spiritual birthday. Let's say it like that, because the 5th of April 1995 is that day where everything changed in my life. And this is today, 23 years ago. It's 23 years ago today, I came into a church for the first time. That was not the Lutheran church. I said, Jesus, I want to follow you. I repent, come. And I experienced the Holy Spirit came into my body. And I met God. I fell in the floor. I experienced the Holy Spirit all over me. And I stood up and my life was changed forever. It was really changed forever. And I experienced God many times since that day. But I never experienced anything like that day. That was the strongest ever I've experienced with the Holy Spirit. It was where I would say today, I know today that I got baptized or filled with the Holy Spirit. It was powerful. And it changed my life forever. I went from hoping, believing that there was a God to knowing that God, he was real. A few weeks before, I was working as a baker and I was looking up in the sky and I said, God, if you are there, come and take me. I want to know you. But at that time, I was thinking of UFO would come and beam me up and fly away with me because I did not know really what to believe at that time. But the 5th of April, 1995, God came, the Holy Spirit came. I met him. I experienced him. And when I jumped on the bicycle and went home, I was like, hello, I know you are there. It was not like, God, if you are there, I know you are there. Why? Because I've experienced you. And since that day, a lot of things have happened. Now I do not only know that he's there, I know him. I know him much better. I've got a relationship with him. And I want to share a little about what I've been learning the last 23 years in my walk with God. A lot of things have happened the last 23 years, and it's special because like a day like this is always a day where I look back. It's always a day like, whoa, it's 23 years ago. I came as 18 years old and I experienced God. If I just knew what I know today. If I look at my life, my walk with God, what I've learned. The first thing I've learned is that people fall away. I don't want to start with the negative. There is a lot of positive thing, but I just need to start here. So many people have fallen away. It is crazy. If I look at, when I think back at that time, like my youth leader who was the one who was there for me, he's not living with God today. He got divorced and lived with a non-Christian woman. To take one example, the friends I had who was there at that time, I look up to as a new believer, they're not living with God today, they're falling away from church. And I've seen so many people fall away. I've seen ministries go wrong. People who are strong in ministry who have gone wrong because of sex or women and power and so on. I've seen so many people get disappointed because of church and fall away. And I've seen so many people who are still in church but are lukewarm. I will also call them fall away, because fall away is not to leave church. Church is the last thing you leave. The first thing you leave is to your first love. If I look at my life now, my wife is, we are parents and grandparents, young grandparents. I'm 41. My wife became 42 yesterday. There is not a lot of people in our generation who are still on fire, who keep going. I see a lot of younger people really, really on fire, but in our generation, I just see many, many people are being deceived by everyday life, by work, by house, by car, by hobby, by school and sports activities and homework. And they're busy, busy, busy with the kids, with the house, with the job, with the friends, with the barbecue, with all of that. And don't have time for God. And slowly life is coming out of them. I don't see a lot of people our age who keep on fire, who keep serving God. So that is one thing I've learned. I've learned that just because you start good don't mean that you end good. just because you now are on fire don't mean that it will continue like this. You need to work on it. And for us to keep ourselves on fire have cost a price in that way that we have lost a lot of friends. We have needed to sometimes move from one city to another to just keep going, because in that city we were in, we felt like things start to draw us down. We have needed to be radical sometimes, say, let's get rid of the house, let's start all over again, because we can see this everyday life is just coming in and we don't want to lose that fire we have now. And I can see now in 23 years, we have never looked back. We have never been away from God. We have never had time where we have been lukewarm, like in long period. We have time where it's been hard, really hard, really, really, really hard. We have cried more than I expected. We have offered more. It cost more. And life has been hard. And sometimes I almost wanted to give up, but at the same time, like, hey, where to go? Jesus, you are the only truth. There's no other place to go. It's just you. And therefore, we have keep going all those years. Now, this is one thing I've learned. I've learned that people fall away. The love of many will grow cold in the end times. And it's so sad to see. Another thing I've learned the last 23 years is that it really costs a price to follow Christ. Also in our Western world, we often think that persecution only in other countries, but it costs here. And everyone who lives a godly life will experience persecution. And the hard thing is where it comes from. That has been a surprise for me. Like people who was close to us, who were spreading lies and rumors, people we thought they were believers, who was false Christians, false friends, in every area, and people who are really lying and manipulating and deceiving. But this is what I read in the Bible also. Paul, he said it. Jesus, one of those 12 was a thief who was part of Jesus. Yeah, you know about Judas. And Paul experiences. So this is one thing I also like. The falling away, big times, the hard times with persecution and so on. One thing I've also seen is the deceitfulness of Satan. And that way that we often as a Christian have that problem that when we get saved into something, we think that what we are in is the only truth. Because as a new believer, you get saved and you don't ask questions as a new believer. So everything you see around you, you accept as a truth. And there, the big glasses come off on already. And you start to read the Bible and see things in a certain way. And I've discovered that is hard to relearn. If we look at the gospel now, I'm getting a lot of critique sometimes by my understanding of the gospel with the Baptist, and the Baptist is part of salvation, and I'm very clear in that. It's part of washing away your sins. It's part of getting rid of the old life you put on Christ. I don't see you can be a born again, full born again believer without being baptized with full immersion after you repent. I don't read that in my Bible. Jesus said, if you want to be born again, you have to be born out of water and spirit. But it's difficult for people to understand because those glasses and because our own experience. Also for me, when I experienced God, I experienced the Holy Spirit the 5th of April 1995. The Holy Spirit came, kaboom, changed my life, fear of dying, disappeared. I was told, congratulations, you are born again. And I thought, hallelujah, I'm born again. And I was preaching the gospel like that for many, many years. I've actually written books, Danish books, they're not translated, Life as a Christian and Fulfill the Race. Those Danish books here, you don't find in English because I don't have them anymore. I've actually burned them. This is some of the last copies I have. And I'm not going to translate them. And I'm not going to sell them anymore. Why? Because it's wrong. Because the way I preach the gospel here is wrong. I don't understand the full gospel yet here with the baptism. Many things are good, but something is wrong. And this is the thing that I see, that many people, when they get saved into a church denomination, they stop learning and they just become like everyone around them. where I found out that we need to study ourselves. It's not enough to just believe what other people around you is saying. You need to study scripture for yourself. You need to examine your life. You need to really go deep yourself. Not trust, just trust other people. Even trust, not trust me. Don't trust anyone with your soul. You need to study yourself. You need to go into scripture. And one of the things for me was, it took me 6 years to really, I experienced God. I for 6 years, I run around saying I got born again the 5th of April, 1995. I don't say that today. Today, I say I started to get born again. I started to get saved because the full salvation had not taken place there. And we did a video about it a few weeks ago called The Road of Salvation. You can find on our YouTube channel. I put a link in here together with this video. And there you can see the road of salvation. That I started to get born again that day. But I need to keep going. I need to continue in Christ. And then it took me 6 years to really get it all. It should have happened the same day, but nobody around me was there to explain me and help me and baptize me. So it took me 6 years to come to that point. But I also know that it's a walk that needs to be walked. I'm not home yet. I'm on the road. I belong to the road, and the road is Jesus Christ. So that is something I also learned. I've seen people fall away. I've learned it's harder than I expected, and we will go through persecution if we live this life. Not if you just believe in, you can believe in God, you can read the Bible and everything is good. It's first when you start to obey it, persecution start. It's first when you come from believing and start to live it, you are dangerous for our enemy and persecution will sit in. You can believe in all the right thing and you can go through life without being persecuted at all, and you are deceived because believing is to obey. That is not a thing. I've seen that, and then the whole thing with being deceived, that we need to be more radical in the word. And for me, I got saved into the faith movement background somehow, word of faith, or I was there for a short time, or the charismatic church. I've left it. I left it. There's just many, 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 many things that I don't believe in today. And I look back at that time and I don't agree with that. I don't agree with this and this and this and this and this, and this is unhealthy and this is not good and this is wrong. And for me, I think for me, there was a time I came from there and I left this and I found people out here who was not charismatic, but who was preaching more sound doctrine in many other ways. And I left from one side to another side and I was there for some time, but then I felt like, dry, like I need more Holy Spirit still, there's something off. And I had a time where I was so frustrated because I thought, shall I really choose between the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, charismatic churches with the life and the healing I want to see, or the sound doctrine in other areas with all of that? But I found out I don't need to choose. We're not called to choose. And I say, if you are in the Reformed background, you need the Holy Spirit. You really need the Holy Spirit. Tongues are for today. Healing are for today. Being led by the Holy Spirit for today. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. The Holy Spirit is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And the Bible explained that very, very clear. The gift have not ceased. The gift is still today. And I recommend you to go and see our new movie, The Last Reformation in the Life, and there you also see it. So are you there? I will say that to you. Are you there where you already believe in the Holy Spirit and gift and speaking tongues? Doctrines, you need doctrines. You really need doctrine. You need to go deeper. You need to understand that sinner's prayer is not for today. It's not about making a decision. It's a life. You need to understand what the full gospel is. You need to understand we don't live by emotion. We don't live by feelings. It's not about emotion. It's not about feelings. We have a foundation, and that is Christ. Jesus Christ is our cornerstone. He's our foundation. He's our rock. And we are built on that rock. And it's not about emotion. It's not about feeling. There is no prosperity teaching. God don't promise us gold and glitter and an amazing life without persecution. That is the American gospel. The American gospel where they just promise you everything, everything is going to be so good. All of that is fake. All of that is fake. Nobody go through life just smiling the whole way and think life is easy. That is fake. That is people who are fake, and we need to be more skeptical. And I see people in the charismatic churches and there over who are deceiving people. I see people who are traveling around with gold dust and diamonds, and they're the same people doing the same stuff again, and they are fake. It's not real. It's not real. It's fake. I don't say God cannot do it, but this is fake. There is people who are cheating. There is wrong people in churches, and I met some of them, and I got disappointed, and I've seen things, and we need to be more skeptical. Just because somebody says the Lord is saying don't mean that it's from God. We need to examine things. We need to examine things, try things, and hold on to what is right. You need to go in Scripture. We need everyone to go in Scripture. And I see a big deception in one side that they believe that the gift and the Holy Spirit is not for today. And then I see a big deception in the other side where they believe that, oh, if it feels good, then it's from God. And so this is what I've learned the last 23 years, that, whoa, the narrow road is really narrow. And there's stitches on each side. And many, many people in the end time is falling away and being deceived. And many will one day stand and say, Lord, Lord, have I not done that? And he say, away from you, I never knew you. And many are like the Pharisees who are seeking Scripture daily to seek Jesus, and they believe there is eternal life in them, but there's not eternal life in Scripture alone. Scripture testify about Jesus, so we may come to him to get life. So life is a journey. Pray, fast, read the word, and keep going. So this is my advice to you today. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep close to him. Flee from sin, flee from sin, flee from sexual sin. If you see sin, flee from it, run away from it. Do something drastic if it is. If you start to drown and be lukewarm, then do something. Do something. It's our decision. It's not enough we wait and see what happened. We need to make radical decisions sometimes. And I can see that some of the reason we are where we are today is because some of the radical decision we make, and it was not decision everyone around us liked. And it had been hard, but God is faithful. Yeah, so this is my thoughts when I'm sitting here the 5th of April, now 2018, and looking back at the last 23 years with God. And I hope to do a video like this next year, next year, next year, and in 30, 40, 50 years, I want to keep in Christ. I want to keep going and not do like we see so often around us. So I hope you got something out of this. I really, really, really encourage you to see our new movie, of course, The Last Breath, Miss in the Life, but also see the Online Pioneer School, because the Online Pioneer School, there is so much truth in it. There is so much thing we need. And I've seen so many people go, as I said, fall away because they don't have the foundation of the word. I know many of you out there who, oh, you just love the healing, you just love that, but we need the fear of God. We need we need everything, not only the excitement, not only those few minutes where you see people, demon coming out and people receive the Holy Spirit, action. I like action. But we need to have a foundation in our life, and that is the Word of God. And I really encourage you to read the Bible yourself, of course. But also, if you can, see the Pioneer School, see the Online Pioneer School. It's for free. I put a link on this video also. God bless you all out there. It is beautiful what God is doing. Beautiful. I thank you all. I thank my friends out there who have been supporting, who are there. We have amazing friends who just love Jesus, and we love them, and it's beautiful, and look forward to see you. Come and visit us here in Denmark, join our PGS school, or Kickstart Weekend. Bye-bye.